And how many of them have got two babies? One of them is Hardcore News, which was mentioned, hardcorenews.com, and you should read it. The other baby is a Hardcore Dialog. Elena is the one, she's a senior research fellow at Norwegian Institute of International Affairs, and she has visited the Hardcore Dialog many times before as well.
Even though it's hard to center over the Arctic areas. So second, Another second special aspect, I think, of hybrid dialogue in the dialogue side is it really is across borders. At least 50%, I think, of our the student participants in hybrid dialogue come from Russia, another very key artist. And that's quite unique in the Arctic context. Finally, perhaps maybe even most importantly, is that hybrid dialogue really strives to be a dialogue across intergenerational lines. Kind of the normal procedure at conferences is that more established people will speak. Maybe you'll hear from younger people if they ask a question, if they do. But we often don't hear from them at all. And hybrid dialogue is really aimed to specialize in emphasizing the future leaders of the Arctic and bringing their experience and their perspectives into active debate, which really makes sense because at these events, we're often talking about the future in which they will be the ones living the longest rather than necessarily those rather than us. So this includes two special formats. Anatoly mentioned the scenario presentations, which was a new feature this year, and involved also some of my students from my course. I thought it was extremely achieved a lot in their very good scenarios. And also the talking barrels, which focuses on bringing especially the voices of different types of leaders from business into focus. So this is a feature that will continue to grow in the next dialogue, which is scheduled for April 5th to 6th in 2017.